Good. I know I've been gone for a little minute, but look, hey, we're not gonna speak on that because I'm here now. 2022 was just an eye-opening year for me with my content and everything I'm trying to do. Kind of made me just be like laser focused on everything. So I just was sitting back, planning on everything, plotting on just everything I'm trying to do in general. Really not executing, but just plotting. But now it's time to put everything in motion. So we back. 2023, we're going strong with all this shit, bro. Monk mode, man. Got a video on Space Haven dropping soon about monk mode. Just being more focused on what it is you're trying to do, where you're trying to go, all that shit. Just having a vision for that shit. So that video will either be linked on the screen or I have it up here in a display card or something. I have it somewhere for y'all, description somewhere. It's pretty much just being locked in on exactly what it is you're trying to do. That's pretty much the end of it. So we locked in on that for the next 6 months. I'm going to drop a video on this channel or Space Haven every week, and I'm going to be streaming. So all of that shit is going to be in motion. And of course, all the socials down below, stay connected through the Discord and, you know, participate in that kind of shit, just more interaction with y'all. So with all of that out the way, I'm going to go ahead and get into my most worn pieces in 2022. I'm going to start with the pants because me personally, that's usually what I base my fits off of about 80-70% of the time. I start with the pants. So one of my most worn pairs of pants this year is Jakov Cargos. Anybody who's in the fashion, like really into the fashion scene on YouTube, know who Jacob Wallace is. Like, I've reviewed these pants before. This is just like a convenient ass pair of pants. It's a cargo pant with, I think, 14 pockets. You can't go wrong with that shit. Like, wearing this, you don't have to carry a side bag. These just some tactical ass pants, really. And I have them in black and in a cream color, but I wear the black more than the cream. I don't know, I feel like these could get dirty quick, but I do rock these as well. Besides the pockets, the material it's made out of is like a neoprene or like some tech fleece material. I don't even know how to, but it's like water bounces off of it. It's easy to clean. You could just wipe it off. They're real durable. Like, all right, next up, I got Wax Denim Rick. Not really too much to be said about it. They're a skinny jean or a slim fit jean, all black, wax denim. Easy to just slip on and put a quick fit together. And if you're just running out, just throw on these black pants. Like, you never can go wrong with black pants. I would wear these pants 4 out of 5 days if I go out. And I think that's a theme you'll see along this video. A lot of the stuff I do wear tends to be black just in general. Trying to add some more color to my wardrobe now. I mean, but I don't even know, because you can never really go wrong with black. So I'm gonna stick with the trend of black pants. And if you've been around the channel for a little minute, you done seen these pants. These are the Vujade like canvas cargos, I think that's what they call. I really don't even know what material this is. I gotta brush up on my materials. If anybody can point me in the right direction to just learn more about the materials these pants is made out of, I would greatly appreciate it. It's just a basic flare black pair of pants. I mean, you'll see how they fit on body right now. Main reason I like these is because of how they fit with a lot of the shoes I wear. A lot of the shoes you'll see, I wear chunky shoes. So of course I'm gonna wear flare pants with them. Can't be walking around out here like Lil Baby and a lot of these rappers, bro. Oh my God, y'all, I don't even know who started that. Y'all gotta leave that shit in 2022. Rocking skinny jeans with big ass Balenciagas. Who dressed you like? Even though it's in the winter time now, this is still one of my most worn pieces on them days. If you live in the South, I live in Atlanta. If you live in the South, you know exactly what I mean. It'll be 20 degrees one day, 70 degrees for the rest of the week, and 20 degrees again. I don't be knowing what the fuck going on. This weather bipolar as fuck. Real shit, they be controlling the weather. That's a different conversation. I call these like the Rick Owens boxing shorts or the Rick Owens gym shorts. These kind of in the same lane of these, the Jakov pants. They're like pretty much the same material. And they have two giant pockets on the side. Like, you can fit everything in these pockets. Fit on these is hard. Like, I love the way these shorts fit. Now, finally, off the black pants, the next pair of pants that I pretty much will wear with whatever, because it's just a hard pair of jeans, is these right here. These blue denim tier jeans. I absolutely cannot get enough wears out of these pants. Like, I will wear these into the ground. Just the fact that, one, it's a Levi, and two, it got like slight designs on it. These right here is like top 3 pieces in my wardrobe out of everything. I love these jeans so much. they fit exactly how you would want a jean to fit, which is another reason why I love them so much. And the way they fall over the shoe just perfect. But denim tears had a crazy wave this year. A lot of people was wearing denim tears. It was a photo I saw ASAP Rocky rocking a denim tears hoodie. I might actually pick that hoodie up soon. And recently, if you saw that Gervonta Davis fight, he was wearing like denim tears styled like boxing shorts. And I'm not gonna lie, them shits was hard. Those are my most worn pants of 2022, so I'm going to get into the shoes now. For the first pair of kicks, if you've been around the channel, tried and true, you done seen these plenty of times, my fucking Miharas, bro. These shoes right here, the Mihara Highs, can't get enough wears out of these. Just like a basic Converse shoe that just got a little sauce on it, you know what I'm saying? Got a little extra sauce on it. And I beat these to the ground, if you can see. I wore these shits to the ground. Like, I put these shoes through it. Like, I'm gonna get my wears out of my shoes. That's one thing. I'm gonna wear my shoes. All right, these next couple pairs of shoes, I'm gonna say them all together because they all the same silhouette of shoes, just different colors. And the shoe I'm talking about is these right here, man. Jordan 4s. You can never go wrong with a pair of Jordan 4s in your collection. There's so many colorways to pick from. And it's like the perfect silhouette of Jordan. Like, it's like these were handcrafted by the fucking Nike gods and Jordan himself. I don't know what they was thinking. They put this silhouette together, but they did some shit. And another silhouette I can't get enough wears out of the Jordan family is the Jordan 1s, but not just any pair. Specifically, man, I love me some Chicago 1s. I can't even lie. God, I alternate these out depending on what fit I'm wearing. If I'm wearing more like a grungy, distressed fit, I'll put these on, and these are 2011 or 2014, whatever year they released, somewhere in that time frame, Chicago 1s, and I didn't put these shoes through it. Oh my God. Don't be afraid to wear your shoes, bro. Might add a little character to them. That's how I look at it. If you got dirty shoes, it's just more character to them. Other pair of Off-White Chicago 1s. Love these shoes right here too. Just same thing they did with the Jordan 4s. They did the same shit with these. Everybody at this point knows Adidas has some of the most comfortable shoes you can own on the market, like out of any company. So of course shoes like Yeezys are gonna be on my list. This is how deep I am with the Yeezy game. Like these shoes are so hard and so comfortable, I had to cop all, these ain't even all the colorways that these came in, but I had to cop just about every colorway that this silhouette came in. But the reason I do fuck with these so heavy is because they just look like some alien shoes or some, these look like on some 2050, 2045 type shit. Like, this man Kanye was really trying to make some futuristic ass shit with this shoe. And I see exactly the vision he was going for, and I fuck with it. But yeah, I don't even know what these are. The seven, I don't know, bro. I'm not even gonna sit here and lie to you, but somebody drop it in the comments. Man, this is one of the, to me, this is one of the hardest shoes that dropped last year. And I fuck with these just because of the memes. You've already seen these on my channel. The Imran potato shoes, just how comfortable and crazy these look. And these always get looks and questions when I'm out, so it's just like a conversation starter. That's another reason I fuck with these. All right, my outerwear this year was a combination of a good bit of stuff, but I'm still trying to get more versatile with it. But for the first piece, I got this. It's just like a post archive blazer, and it has like these asymmetrical cuts on it. The sleeves are cut different, like the sleeves are like flared at the end. And it's like that same fleece material I was telling you about with the Jakeoff pants. It's just like a light jacket, and it just looks good. Like, it's a, you could pull this off in a casual setting. You could pull this off on like a party setting, just going to get brunch. If you want to put a like hard fit together, you could layer this with something. It's like, this jacket is versatile as hell. This next hoodie right here might be like my hardest hoodie in my collection. And it was one of my hardest pickups, I feel like, in the last couple months. This piece, when I came across this, I was like, yeah, I just had to cop it. And it's this Warren Lotus, don't mind the stains on it, but it's this Warren Lotus hoodie. Not too much going on the front, but on the back, this graphic is crazy. If you know Warren Lotus, you know how his art is. This right here is, I think this is Steve Nash, number 13 on the Suns. I think this is Steve Nash, but this jacket, just the quality of this is like the same quality as like those thick Yeezy Gap hoodies. and it fits the same like crop, and it has the graphic on the back. So I'm just like, bruh. And another thing, it has a big hood. I love big hood hoodies, and it's well worth the price. Like, that hoodie was like almost $200-$250. Another one of my most worn hoodies is this Represent hoodie right here. Spoke on this before. You probably seen this in one of my past videos, in one of my older pickup videos, but ever since then, like, I get my wares out of this hoodie. One of my favorite things about it is it has this button like by the hood, so you can like close up the hood just like that Warren Lotus hoodie. I love big prints on jackets. All right, this hoodie right here, I feel like is one of my more unique hoodies just because of the fit and just everything about it. Here's the tag right here, if you can see it, or I had that shit zoomed in on B-roll. And it's another cropped hoodie. The yellow on the hoodie contrasts well with the burgundy and the red on it. I get asked a lot where I got this hoodie from when I wear it. Like I said, I don't know the name of the brand, so I can never really tell nobody. I just like, I don't know, I found it on Grail. And last but not least, you gotta have a jacket when it's raining outside, or, you know, just to fight the elements. And right here is this Norfeet. Got this
North Face fleece.
Damn, that's crazy. I can't even say that shit. North Face fleece jacket. God damn. This right here, I just throw this on when it's raining, or I like to go hiking. This kind of reminds me of like an Arc'teryx jacket. It's kind of along the same lines as that. Like, if I wanted to, I could get in the shower wearing this, but I'm not about to do that. Y'all niggas be tripping. Oh, and a hard feature on this jacket right here, it has like this kangaroo pouch that you can fit like a lot of stuff in. So like, when you out in the wild or wherever you decide to wear the jacket, you got a kangaroo pouch. You could dead ass fit an iPad in here. I had my iPad in here one day when I was walking around. For the last section of this video, I'm gonna do the accessories and bags as a whole, because I feel like they fit in the same category. All right, this bag right here, if you see me in person, you'll probably see this bag with me like 8 times out of 10. This little puffer side bag, as you can see, I got dirt and shit on it right here. Like, I put this bag through it, but it's not too much to be said about it. It's just one big ass pocket in here and a little coin purse just to hold my change and shit, or whatever I want to put in there. Might have some gas in it, you never know. Next is this little low-key Nike like chest bag. I use this when I'm like about to go work out, I'm going to the gym, or like I'm about to go on a quick run or something like that. Like, if I got this, I really only carry in like my phone on me and my wallet, the grab and go bag, like I'll be right back type shit. Next up for the jewelry is my rings, and I really only rock like 2 rings, so, and I alternate between these. Sometimes I wear both, sometimes I just wear one of them. It's this Chrome Hearts ring and this Gucci ring that I'm like always wearing when I want to just depends on the fit and what I'm going for. So yeah, just these 2 rings right here. I feel like rings is an essential in your collection. Like, of course, a lot of people know that already, but a lot of people still don't even be wearing rings like that. You could literally get points on your fit just for adding rings to your fit. And of course, I can't forget about the Chrome Hearts chain I'm always wearing. This is like everyday piece for me. This is my everyday jewelry. This Chrome Hearts chain and a ring that goes with it, I got these in a set together. So if I'm wearing one, I'm pretty much gonna be wearing the other. So if you made it this far in the video, man, I appreciate you. That means you really fucking with me. Go ahead and leave a like, subscribe, and go subscribe to the Space Haven channel too. Link to all that will be in the description. But that right there is my most worn pieces of 2022. I appreciate everybody for stopping by. Like I said, kicking it with me again on the video. This ain't even just about to be a fashion channel. I'ma just include more me on this channel, bro. Regardless of what we do or what we dropping, just know it's up from here. Oh.